Hare Krishna. The mind overpowers us by making us believe that we are powerless. Whenever we face situations in which we are disempowered, in which we feel that we have no power, that we just can't do anything at that time, that feeling is often our greatest enemy. And that feeling is a trick of the mind. Just like in a battle or in a confrontation, the enemy uses the strategy of intimidation and scares the opponent so that the opponent gives up without a fight. Similarly, the mind deludes us into believing that we are powerless. And how does it do that? By making our attention fixated on the things that have gone wrong, the things that are not in our control, the things about which we are powerless. And yes, often things go terribly wrong and we are powerless about many things in life, but we are not powerless about everything. This difference is critical and the mind makes us forget that. If we think that we are powerless, this is such a situation, I just can't do anything about it. A simple way to counter the mind's illusion of powerlessness is to ask ourselves, can I make things worse? Obviously, no matter how bad things are, we always have the power to make them worse. And if we have the power to make them worse, then we have the power to make them better also. And we always have power over our consciousness, over our attitude. And what approach do we use for looking at the problems? So whenever we feel powerless, if we recognize that this feeling is an illusion created by the mind, and then we reject that feeling, at least that much power we have. And how can we tap that power better? By accessing our spiritual side, by remembering that we are souls who are different from our minds, and by remembering that as souls we are parts of the whole. We are parts of Krishna, and if we connect with Him, then we gain even more power because we access His supreme power. The Bhagavad-Gita says in 15:7, Mamaivamsho jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatanaha manashasthani indriyani prakritisthani karshati. That as long as we stay connected with Krishna, we are safe. But as soon as we lose the connection with Him, then we are dragged here and there by our mind and senses. So that sense of powerlessness, of being pulled by this, swept away by the situations, helplessly, that comes upon us when we are disconnected from Krishna. When we connect with Krishna, gain strength by that connection, and then pray, Krishna, how can I serve you in this situation? Our vision will shift from that which is not in our control to that which is in our control, and we will create thereby a better future for ourselves, no matter how dark our present may be. Thank you. Hare Krishna.